This is for the Dan Brown Video Contest. Hi there, my name is Paul. Dan, I happen to like your videos. I thought your videos on how to solve a Rubik's Cube were especially great. And being agnostic myself, I thought your open letter to God was an interesting argument. But there's one thing I'd like to recommend. I'm doing this with equipment that costs less than $50. The camera costs $12, my headset cost about $15, and the tripod it's sitting on cost about $8. So that's cheap. But there is one thing that is basically precious and irreplaceable, and that's the ability to understand what you're saying. And that's why I'd like to recommend, when you say something important, that you consider captioning your video. The reason is, people who can't hear have no idea what you're saying. And this is the thing I notice also with people who can't hear. They will do video in which they will do whatever they do for sign language movements. But since they can't hear, they don't know how to speak, they don't say anything. Now, I've seen some deaf people who do caption their videos, and that's a good idea because it's for the vast majority of people who don't understand sign language that it helps. But for people like us who can hear, it can be very helpful to make videos available for those who don't. I'm also going to include some reasons from a previous video I did, so I'd like you to also look at the following. I'd like to recommend that you consider captioning videos, especially ones that you're uploading to video sites like YouTube and many others. There are several reasons for doing so. First and foremost, it provides accessibility to those who can't hear. Also, for the benefit of people who are not native speakers of English, it provides a means to help them learn the language. But when you cut out a large number of people, either because you don't make what you're saying available to those who can't hear, or those of you who make it unavailable to those who can't read sign language, you're doing a disservice to your audience who might be interested in what you have to say. And unless you're interested in getting the audience to listen, or read, or view what you have to say, why are you putting up a video?